disintermediate, recontextualize, and visioneer. You've got to give business executives one thing: they love their jargon. Clinging to their buzzwords like a black lab to a tennis ball, there are managers out there who throw around words like constructivist, interdisciplinary, metacognitive, or inquiry-centered, and then tack them onto nouns like bandwidth, convergence, and methodologies. And you're well on your way to a minor stroke trying to process it all. You mean we should triangulate meaning-centered cohorts? Or are we focused more on synthesizing technology-enhanced convergence? Communication doesn't have to be, or shouldn't be, this hard. And the more you get to communicate with the big bosses in the boardroom, you'll learn something rather refreshing: they hate it too. Surprised? Don't be. There's much more power and clarity in simple communication, and the economic impact is surprisingly quantifiable. The University of Maryland School of Business measured a titanic loss of $12 billion annually to the U.S. healthcare system, attributed in large part to poor and inefficient communication among doctors, nurses, and other healthcare providers. A single 500-bed hospital, according to the research, suffers losses of over $4 million annually due to various communication inefficiencies. Communicating really shouldn't be this tricky, but it's no secret why so many of us feel a need to boast and bluster. Most up-and-coming business professionals assume that if they don't lace a speech, meeting, or memo with at least a few high-minded phrases or words, people will think they're lacking brain power. Here's a little experiment that might change your mind, especially if one considers that the purpose of good communication is to convey a memorable message. Here are examples of the same thing said two very different ways. A, the vicissitudes of our earthly existence are disproportionately distributed. Or B, life is not fair. A, a mutually shared understanding of the zeitgeist produces a commonality of analytical outlook. Or B, it takes one to know one. A, it is inadvisable to reject the totality of something if there is possible value in a component part. Or B, don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. If you answered A to all of the above, you might want to settle into your cubicle for the long haul, because only leaders who know how to speak plain English get tapped for corner office status. That said, if you answered B, you get the picture. I'm Renee Cohn for the Job Channel Network.